लेट अस नाउ कंटिन्यू विद द डिस्कशन ऑफ रेक्टिफायर्स. सो पी एन जंक्शन डायोड्स आर ऑल्सो यूज फॉर द पर्पज ऑफ रेक्टिफिकेशन. सो वॉट आर रेक्टिफायर्स? रेक्टिफायर्स आर द डिवाइसेस विच कन्वर्ट द अल्टरनेटिंग करंट इंटू डायरेक्ट करंट. रेक्टिफायर्स आर द डिवाइसेस विच कन्वर्ट अल्टरनेटिंग करंट इंटू डायरेक्ट करंट. हाउ डू वी अचीव दिस? सो वी यूज़ द प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ पी एन जंक्शन डायोड. वी नो दैट पी एन जंक्शन डायोड ओनली अलाउज द करंट टू फ्लो इन वन डिरेक्शन. वेन इट इज़ इन फॉरवर्ड बायस वी हैव हाई करंट, एंड वेन वी आर इन रिवर्स बायस द करंट इज ऑलमोस्ट नेग्लिजिबल. सो दिस प्रॉपर्टी दैट डायोड ओनली अलाउज द करंट टू फ्लो इन वन डिरेक्शन, इट विल बी यूज इन द प्रोसेस ऑफ रेक्टिफिकेशन. सो मेनली वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट टू टाइप्स ऑफ रेक्टिफायर्स. वन विल बी द हाफ वेव रेक्टिफायर, हाफ वेव रेक्टिफायर, एंड अनादर वन विल बी द फुल वेव रेक्टिफायर. सो हाफ वेव एंड फुल वेव रेक्टिफायर्स आर क्वाइट सिमिलर, जस्ट द डिफरेंस इज दैट इन हाफ वेव रेक्टिफायर वी हैव ओनली वन डायोड, इन फुल वेव रेक्टिफायर वी विल हैव टू डायोड्स. सो हाउ विल बी द सर्किट लुक लाइक? सो द सर्किट विल लुक लाइक समथिंग लाइक दिस फॉर हाफ एंड फुल वेव रेक्टिफायर्स. सो लेट्स से वी हैव दिस प्राइमरी कॉइल हियर एंड another secondary coil over here. Now what if we add a diode in this circuit, in the secondary coil, and we can observe we can obtain the output from here. So this is our load resistance. We will obtain the output voltage from this part, and here we are giving in some input which is alternating in nature. So alternating input is given over here. So now let's first understand half wave rectifier, then we'll move on to the full wave rectifier. So the input will look like this. Let's draw them together. So let's say the input looks like this. Alternating current is there, so it will be a sinusoidal wave. Now first let's start with the positive cycle. So this is our positive cycle. So in the positive cycle, this part, let's say, is positive and this part is negative. Positive terminal, negative terminal. So because of the principle of mutual induction, here positive and negative terminals or EMF will be induced. Now if this is the case, then notice closely, the p-type is connected with the positive terminal and the n-type is connected with the negative terminal. So this is in forward bias, and we know that if it is in forward bias, then there will be current like this. Okay, so there will be a current when the diode gets the positive cycle. Now what happens if the diode gets the negative cycle? So in the negative cycle, this terminal will be negative and the below terminal will be positive. Okay, in the second cycle, negative cycle, we have a negative upper side and positive lower side. So in that case, we will obtain negative here and positive here. So because of that, what will happen is that this will be in contact with p-type, will be in contact with negative terminal, and the n-type will be in contact with the positive terminal. So what will happen? So it will become reverse bias. So in reverse bias, we know that there will not be any current. So in the negative cycle, no current will be there. But then again, positive cycle will come. So positive, and the same process. So we will get the positive cycle as it is, like this. बट देन अगेन इन नेगेटिव साइकिल वी विल नॉट गेट एनी वेव. सो वॉट इज़ हैपनिंग इज दैट वाई इज़ इट कॉल्ड हाफ वेव रेक्टिफिकेशन, बिकॉज हाफ ऑफ द वेव्स आर कट ऑफ एंड वी ओनली ऑब्टेन वेव्स इन पर्टिकुलर डिरेक्शन. फॉर एग्जाम्पल इन दिस केस ओनली पॉजिटिव साइकिल्स आर अवेलेबल, नेगेटिव साइकिल्स आर कट ऑफ. इफ वी डू वन थिंग, इफ वी चेंज द डिरेक्शन, if we change the direction of the diode, if diode becomes like this, so in this case you will observe that negative cycle will be there and positive cycle will be cut off. So let's draw the cycle here also. So what we will have in the positive cycle, if you notice, it will become, this will be positive, so this is n-type, so n-type is connected with positive terminal, so it is reverse bias. So in positive cycle no current will be there, but in negative cycle, remember this is minus, so this is negative, so n-type is connected with negative, so we will be in forward bias, so we will obtain the current and the direction will be anti-clockwise like this. So we will obtain a current in the negative part, but again in positive part we will not obtain any current, then again in negative part we will obtain the current or voltage. So this is how the half wave is rectified. So in half wave rectification we clip off one of the direction and only one direction is available for the transmission, so we obtain DC like this. So this is one example and this is another example. Now let's discuss about full wave rectifier. So full wave rectifier is quite similar, it is quite similar. The only difference is there will be two diodes. So how? So we will have another diode here and let's put the output at a different location. So let's say we will obtain the output from here. This is V out, this is load resistance RL. Now let's put a diode over here. So this is the situation. So now what will happen is that when we apply the positive cycle, let's also draw this. So when we apply positive cycle, what will happen? Let's say this is diode D1, this is diode D2. So this diode will, this is positive, this part will be negative, this one will be positive and this part will be negative. Okay. So this upper diode is forward bias and the lower diode is reverse bias, because negative is connected with positive and in the upper part positive is connected with the P-type. So this is what we will have. Upper diode will be forward, lower diode will be reverse biased. Now, so because of that, the current will be in this direction. If you notice closely, the diode, the symbol of the diode tells us about the direction of current. Okay. So the positive cycle will be present in the, this is input, this is output, input, output. Now what will happen in the negative cycle? In the negative cycle, this will be negative, so this will be negative, so this will be positive, this will be negative and this will be positive. So this lower diode becomes forward bias and this upper diode becomes reverse bias. So the lower diode will conduct current but upper diode will not conduct any current. So again the direction will be like this, लाइक दिस. सो इफ यू नोटिस क्लोजली वॉट इज हैपनिंग इज दैट इन दिस पार्ट द करंट इज इन द सेम डिरेक्शन इन बोथ द साइकल्स पॉजिटिव एज वेल एज नेगेटिव साइकिल. सो द करंट विल बी लाइक दिस एंड अगेन पॉजिटिव साइकिल विल कम इन द इनपुट सो वी विल ऑब्टेन दिस एंड फॉर नेगेटिव अगेन सेम विल बी देयर. सो वी हैव रेक्टिफाइड द कम्प्लीट साइकिल वी हैव ऑब्टेन द करंट इन ओनली वन डिरेक्शन एंड सिमिलरली दिस कैन बी the direction of the diets can be changed and we will obtain only negative we will obtain the current in negative direction or anti-clockwise direction if we change the direction of the diets. So let's say the situation becomes like this. Okay, direction of the diets is changed. So in this situation, the direction of the current will also change. What will happen is that current will be flowing in this direction in both the cases, that is in this direction. So we will have only the negative cycle. So only negative cycle will be present and the positive cycles will also be converted into negative cycle. So this is full wave rectification. So rectifier is a device which converts direct current into alternating current into direct current using the property of diode that they conduct electricity in only forward bias and not in reverse bias. So now let's move on to another device, and that device is the transistor. So as discussed earlier, transistor is a three-terminal device. Transistor is a three-terminal device called a triode, and it has various applications. We will be discussing about BJT only, bipolar junction transistor only. So let's start with the transistor, and which transistor? Bipolar junction transistor. Bipolar junction transistor. Why bipolar? Because we have two polarity, electrons and holes are there. So first of all, what is a transistor? So it is a device which has many purposes, multi-purpose device. Purpose device which can be used for amplification, storage, switching, etc. So how does the bipolar junction transistor works? So first of all, let's suppose that we have a situation in which we have a device having three terminals or three regions. Now there can be two scenarios. First scenario is that we have a p-type region on the sides and there is a n-type region in between. Or second scenario, we could have n-type region on the sides and a p-type region in between. So this three terminal device, three terminals are emitter, base and collector. So these are the three terminals that we have: emitter, base and collector. So let's say this is emitter, this is base and this is collector. So emitter एंड कलेक्टर आर ऑफ द सेम टाइप ऑफ सेमी कंडक्टर एंड बेस इज ऑफ अ डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ अ सेमी कंडक्टर. सो दिस इज अ थ्री टर्मिनल डिवाइस हैविंग इधर पी एन पी कन्फिग्रेशन और एन पी एन टाइप ऑफ कन्फिग्रेशन. नाउ वॉट इज दिस एंड हाउ डज इट वर्क, इट विल टेक सम टाइम टू अंडरस्टैंड. सो लेट्स टेक एन पी एन ट्रांजिस्टर एज एन एग्जाम्पल. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वन इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग टू नोट इज द सिम्बल फॉर द ट्रांजिस्टर इज लाइक दिस. Like this, three terminals are drawn. Now, this is emitter, this is base, and this is collector. A circle is drawn. Now, in case of a PNP transistor, the direction of flow of current will be like this. That is from emitter to base. But in case of NPN transistor, the direction of current will be like this. That is from base to emitter. So these are the symbols that we use for PNP and NPN transistors. So let's take the example of any of the transistors. So let's say this is NPN transistor consisting of emitter, base and collector. So now, what are the properties of emitter, base and collector, and we will understand that why are those properties important. So first of all, base. So base is first of all very thin compared to other two. Apart from this, the majority carriers emitted by emitter do not recombine much with this base because it is very thin and doping is moderate. That is, impurities that are added are moderate, not much, not less as compared to other two. Then in the case of emitter, it is thick than base, or you can say it is thicker than base, but it is thinner than the collector. So thicker than base, thinner than collector, and it is highly doped. Its doping is highest. And collector part is thickest and its doping is less than emitter but more than collector, more than base. So in terms of doping and in terms of thickness, so scenario is this: doping is highest in collector, highest in emitter, then in collector, then in base, and thickness highest for collector, then for emitter, then for base. So this you have to remember. So why is base there? So base acts as a intermediary and majority of the charge carriers emitted by emitter pass through the base and go to collector junction. So इट एक्ट्स एज अ चैनल, इट एक्ट्स एज अ चैनल फॉर द फ्लो ऑफ चार्जेस, चार्ज कैरियर्स, वेदर दे आर इलेक्ट्रॉन्स और वेदर दे आर होल्स. सो वी हैव अ थ्री टर्मिनल डिवाइस इन विच द करंट पास थ्रू वन टर्मिनल टू अनादर टर्मिनल. दिस मिडिल टर्मिनल एक्ट्स एज अ चैनल थ्रू विच द चार्ज कैरियर्स कैन पास थ्रू. नाउ वी हैव टू टाइप्स ऑफ, लेट्स राइट द सिनेरियोस. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल टाइप्स, सो वी हैव टू टाइप्स ऑफ ट्रांजिस्टर्स, पीएनपी ट्रांजिस्टर एंड एनपीएन ट्रांजिस्टर. सो दिस आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ ट्रांजिस्टर्स दैट वी हैव. नेक्स्ट वी हैव कॉन्फ़िगरेशन ऑल्सो, वी विल अंडरस्टैंड दिस इन अ मोमेंट. सो वी हैव डिफरेंट कॉन्फ़िगरेशंस लाइक कॉमन एमिटर कॉन्फ़िगरेशन, कॉमन एमिटर एमिटर कॉन्फ़िगरेशन, देन अ कॉमन बेस कॉन्फ़िगरेशन एंड देन अ कॉमन कलेक्टर कॉन्फ़िगरेशन, कॉमन कलेक्टर कॉन्फ़िगरेशन. Now also there is a different region in which the transistor can operate. You will understand everything in a moment. So there are three regions in which the transistor can operate. One is saturation region, one is active region and one is cutoff region. So these three regions are there in which the transistor can operate. So let's make things simple. First of all, it is easy to understand the types. So we can have either PNP or NPN. This is simple. Now what is this configuration? So we know that transistor is a three terminal device. Transistor is a three terminal device. So because of that, we usually need four terminals. We need four terminals, two input and two output terminals, but transistor only has three terminals. So therefore we make one of the terminals to be common in both input as well as output. So in common emitter configuration, emitter is used in both input and as well as in output. In common base, base is used in both input and as well as in output. And in common collector is used in both input as well as in output. So here base is used in both, and here collector is used in both input and output. So we want four terminals, two inputs and two outputs. So because of that, we need to have one terminal common, as we only have three terminals. Okay, so hopefully this is clear that what is this configuration. So usually common emitter configuration is used most of the times. So configuration is a situation in which we make one of the terminal common for both input and output. Now what is this region? So now what happens is that we have two regions. One is the input region and one is the output region. So if both input and output regions are made forward bias, so then we are operating the transistor in the saturation region. If input is in forward bias but the output is in reverse bias, then we are operating the transistor in active region. And if both input and output are in reverse bias, then we call it cutoff region. So usually we will have a transistor in the active region. So now these three things you need to keep in mind. First of all, most commonly NPN transistor is used in common emitter configuration and it is operated in active region so that we can use it as an amplifier. So this is common. It does not mean that this is only case, but most commonly amplifiers are made using NPN transistor in common emitter configuration and operating in the active region. So we will understand about the working of amplifier using this NPN transistor, common emitter configuration and an active region. So first of all, let us draw the transistor and let's try to understand the working of the transistor and try to understand how does it amplify the signal. So let's take a common emitter configuration. So let's say this is the region where we are applying some input. So let's say we are applying VCC input, output region is this. And let's say we are applying some input here. Okay, some input is given over here. Let's say this is our NPN transistor, so the arrow will be outside, emitter, base and collector. Now this is NPN, remember NPN. So this is reverse bias, if you can clearly see positive and n-type. Now we need to make it forward bias, so this will be like this. If you notice closely, n is with negative, p is with positive. So this is forward bias. So now the direction of current will be like this, IB current will be here, IC current will be like this. And IE current will be like this. Let's say there is some resistance over here, which is load resistance RL. So the output voltage will be here like this. And this is sometimes called VC. So now this is common emitter NPN active region amplifier. Okay, so now what happens is that when we know that this part is forward biased and this part is reverse biased, so we know one thing: current here will be high and resistance will be low. Okay, remember. Now what happens is that the current from the input side goes to the output side. So although in reverse bias current is less, but here current will be more because the current passes from input side to the output side. But in reverse bias, the resistance is high. So what happens is that the resistance keeps itself high, but the current is high because the input gives the current to output. So we have more current but less resistance here, and more current and high resistance here. So what is happening is that the that's why I call the transistor transfer of resistance. Okay, so what is happening is that in the input side the power is less and in the output side the power is more. So this is how the amplification is occurring. This is how amplification is happening. Okay. Because power is I square R. So input power is less than the output power. As here current is more but resistance is less. Here current is more, also the resistance is more. So this is how the amplification happens. Now let's do some, let's write some equations as well. So first of all, you can easily see from the diagram, IE is equal to IB plus IC. Also VCC is equal to, or VC is equal to VCC minus ICRL, okay. This VC is equal to VCC minus ICRL. So this is one of the equation as well. We can replace it using VCE also, no problem with that. So VC is the voltage between emitter and collector. This can be VCE also. So this is the voltage between emitter and collector. Now the important thing is this. In common emitter amplifier, input signal is 180 degree out of phase from the output signal. So this means, let's say if we draw the input and output graph, this will be the input like this. So output will look like this, 180 out of phase. This is input, this is output. So in the common emitter configuration, the input and output are 180 degree out of phase. Now let's try to find the current gains and different voltage and resistance ratios. So first of all, DC current gain. So this is quite simple. It is represented by beta. So it is output current, that is IC, upon input current, that is IB. Next is the AC current gain. So if you apply alternating current, so in that case beta AC will be change in the output current over change in the input current. Then we have another ratio called the resistance ratio. So resistance ratio is quite simple, output resistance over input resistance. Next is the voltage gain, AC voltage gain. So it is again quite simple, voltage gain is represented by A. So del V output voltage upon del V input voltage. So output voltage is VC, input voltage is VB. So if you put the value here, you will obtain ICR out. This is output voltage and input voltage is IB R in. So AV is equal to beta AC into resistance ratio. Next is the power gain. So power gain is quite simple. Power gain is equal to output power over input power, which will be like this. आई स्क्वायर आर. सो पावर गेन इज बीटा इसी इंटू बीटा एसी स्क्वायर इंटू रेजिस्टेंस रेशियो, और पावर गेन कैन बी बीटा एसी इंटू एवी दैट इज करंट गेन इंटू वोल्टेज गेन, और पावर गेन कैन ऑल्सो बी एवी स्क्वायर ओवर रेजिस्टेंस रेशियो. ऑल दिस कैन बी यूज. सो दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. पावर गेन, पावर गेन इज द मेन रीजन बिहाइंड द एम्पलीफिकेशन. So what are the uses of the transistor? So first, it is used as an amplifier. It can also be used as an oscillator. It is used as a switch as well. It is used for storage as well of memory. So there are multiple applications or uses of transistor. So in different configuration you can operate the transistor and obtain desirable application.